happy years, I kept them in my heart. Yeah, the time of our lives, it was all about fun.
And then,
morning.
So, we are. So, today's plans. So, we're nipping back to SeaWorld.
Yep, just to see if we can do an exchange and grab a t-shirt.
And then we will be heading to Animal Kingdom, depending on what the times are, for what we need to do. And then it will be Hollywood Studios. We've just had a quick FaceTime with Donna and Joe, so it's nice to see them. So let's start our day. So after a quick trek through SeaWorld, sorted out photos, then we got them all back.
Yeah, that's all sorted.
So now we've just driven to Animal Kingdom, going to do the Lion King show. Got to pick up a few bits, and then we've got Lightning Lane at Kilimanjaro Safari.
We have succumbed to Disney Genie Plus, just because it has been busy the last couple of days. Matt and Ali used Disney Genie Plus yesterday and managed 11 rides with it. And we want to go to Hollywood Studios later. There's a few things we want to get done there. So we've bit the bullet and we're trying it out. It's not something we wanted to do, but we'll see how it goes.
It was a bit awkward to first set up, like, or where to find it once you purchased it, but that's it, right? Heading to Lion King. So Lion King is not happening. The queue was really long. Couldn't get in. Lightning Lane was going through as well. Went to the end of the line, which is like this place, which I never noticed before. It's a bridge to go on somewhere, and look, so that's not going to happen. Next one's in an hour, I think.
2 hours.
About 2 hours. We've got Lightning Lane at 2:05 for Safari. So, these are the only two things we want to do, but
like they're
like they're even queuing still.
The only thing is people still joined up for us.
Or they're waiting for the next show, I don't know. But it's a very busy day at this park. SeaWorld was, when we went to go and sort out the photos, it was dead.
Yeah, really quiet today, especially in comparison to yesterday.
Yeah, whether here now it's
everything just seems busy. To be against us today.
Yeah, not a very good morning, but hopefully that changes when we go to Hollywood Studios.
Safari guide out here on the Hirono Wildlife Reserve. We'll be heading into the reserve in just a second. But before we head in, I do have a few very quick safety reminders. We do need to make sure we are staying seated at all times with our hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the truck. But over to your left, there are some bongos first thing. And then to your right is an okapi. So the okapi is all the way back there. And these ones closer to us on your right are greater kudus.
Oh, those are kudus.
Now the okapi is a pretty cool animal. That one's one of my favorites out here. If you take a look at that okapi, like I said, it's all the way back there on the right. You might see some zebra-looking stripes on their backsides. But despite these zebra-looking stripes, they are not related to the zebra at all. But over to your left, there is a black rhino.
What?
It's camouflaged.
Now, black rhinos are in danger. There's only about 5,000 of them left in the entire world. That 5,000 is combined between zoos, reserves like this one, and out in the wild. The next area we'll be in is the Safi River. Your best bet to spot some animals will be to look down into the water. We do have two areas of water we will be going through, one on our right and one on our left. The left one is a little easier to spot animals in, mostly because it doesn't look like there's anything on the right right now. But those large grayish-white birds you see out on the island are pink-backed pelicans.
That one looks like a hippo.
They are named for the pink coloring they get on their backs, but that pink coloring does only appear during mating season. Pinkback pelican can get a wingspan of up to about 9 feet. Just to kind of give you an idea of how big that is, The canopy right above your head from left to right is just over 9 feet.
There's another one.
You look down to your left, there is a hippo down there in the water. Looks kind of like a big floating rock. Just make sure everybody is staying seated, guys. Everybody does need to be seated.
Mom, is that the rope board?
That used to be the alligator.
No, hippos do swim pretty well. You might have seen that one walking along the riverbed. That is actually their preferred mode of transportation. Like I said, they can swim, but they prefer to just walk or run along the riverbed. Another thing about the savannah, there's not going to be as much trees and shrubs covering our view. You might not believe me right this second because all we can currently see is trees and shrubs, but now, just like our fingerprints, each coat on an African painted dog is completely individual. No two are exactly alike. They are actually endurance hunters, so what this means, they can keep up their speeds for long periods of time, and in most cases, their prey does drop from exhaustion. And then a little further up ahead, these are springbok right here. Springbok are appropriately named because they are very good jumpers. From a standstill position, they can actually jump up to 6 feet straight up and 13 feet forward.
Termites!
It looks like we're gonna find some giraffes over ahead to our left. Before we get to the giraffes though, there's some wildebeest over there on your right as well. Like I said, these giraffes are gonna be on our left. Wild Africa Trek Trucks is moving just in time. We should be able to make a quick stop for these giraffes right here. There they are. This is one of their favorite spots to hang out. The entire group is over here. Group of giraffes is appropriately referred to as a tower. But these tower of giraffes can get up to 18 to 20 feet tall. They are the tallest land animals. Baby giraffes do start their lives off pretty tall because they are born at about 6 feet tall. There they are. There's one of them. Two of them. Now these are African elephants. You can tell the difference between an African and an Asian elephant based on the shapes of their ears. So guys, we cannot be switching seats. We do need to make sure our seats are permanent. But if you ever happen to see an African elephant flapping their ears, they're not trying to fly. What they are actually trying to do is cool themselves off. Because by flapping their ears, they can cool themselves off by up to 15 degrees. But the cool thing about those matriarchal herds, they will be led by the oldest female. This is done because elephants do have a fantastic sense of memory. So, that oldest female will usually remember every food and watering spot she has ever been to, at least the ones that she wants to remember. So in order to prevent that information from being lost to her younger herd mates, she'll lead her herd mates there. That way that information can continue to be passed out. There they are.
They use a yell back.
Now, looks like these elephants are currently using their trunks to grab a snack, but they can use their trunks for a wide variety of reasons. Like I said, they can pick up food. They can also suck up water or dirt to spray on their backs to cool themselves off. But elephants can also shape their environments with their trunks. So they can push and pull heavy objects like tree trunks and tree logs. But they can also be incredibly precise with those trunks. Elephant can actually pick up a single blade of grass with their trunks if they'd like to. But over to your left, those are greater flamingos. They do start their lives off gray in color. And as they get older, they start to eat brine shrimp and other things like that. That is where their famous pink coloring will come from. Now, this animal to your left is a waterbuck. They are appropriately named because they like to hang out by the water. They actually do secrete an oily substance that will coat their fur and essentially make their fur waterproof. But it does also serve a hidden secret purpose. That oily secretion does stink, doesn't smell very good, so it does help to deter predators from attacking them. Let's Speaking of predators, well, first of all, a rhino. That is a white rhino. Wow, is this one gonna go hide too as soon as we see it? It was over there, I swear. Somebody else saw it too.
I did.
That's the encouragement I need. But then over to your left, those are some warthogs all the way back there. There is one a little closer too. He's rolling in the mud. There he goes. He heard us. He's like, nope. Now you might recognize these warthogs as Pumbaa from The Lion King. I would not necessarily call them that to their faces, though. It does mean foolish in Swahili. There are some Nigerian dwarf goats over here. They're pretty funny animals. But they do serve a few different purposes out here on the reserve. They are very good at eating up some of the vegetation that the other animals are not incredibly fond of. But they do also produce a very sweet milk that we will harvest and sell to the village to help stimulate the economy down there. A silly little fun fact about the Nigerian dwarf goats, at least the ones out here, none of them like the rain. So if you ever come on the safari when it's raining, every single one of the Nigerian dwarf goats will be huddled underneath that little awning.
So we've just done the queued 8 minutes for the Kilimanjaro safari, which went pretty quick. We met an American family out of there, didn't we? They were lovely. So if you're watching, hi guys.
Lovely chatting to you.
Yeah. And
certainly made that last hour go very quick.
Very, very. So we've done Kilimanjaro, and then we've just rushed because literally we had 10 minutes to get to the Lion King.
For the Lightning Lane, and we pretty much have taken like the last seats, two of our seats in this section.
So that was just Lightning Lane. So I think everybody queuing, them getting, so.
There must be some jam guests.
There's gotta be a couple.
But if this is all right in the lane, that is very unfair.
Yeah, but everybody was in before and they didn't even let general queue, and all these people are in here. So yeah, if you want to watch a show, by the looks of it, Lightning Lane is the way to go. And you just think everybody's paid $15 a day for this. We're one of them. You know, you can see why Disney's making the money.
Earning some money.
Yeah. So anyway, so we're going to watch Lion King.
Explorers and adventurers. Welcome to Hollywood Studios for the Festival of the Lion King. Greetings, everyone. Habari. Welcome. We have been expecting you. We are here today to welcome you, one and all, to the Festival of the Lion King. Wonderful, right on time. Everyone, listen. to you, His Majesty, the Lion King.
Welcome, everyone. It's me, Simba. You've all picked a very special day to visit. You see, today, we've come to town for a big celebration, and you, my friends, are invited to join in the fun.
Come on, everyone. Get ready to clap your paws, stomp your hooves, and ruffle your feathers as we welcome you to the Festival of... Center stage! Who's driving this thing?
So proud! I'm glad you could make it. We can't have this celebration without you. Don't worry, Fred. You'll get your time in the spotlight.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
To be king!
Hello!
Hello!
Hello! Look at me! I'm in a parade!
enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with me.
Oh,
century. Be prepared for the murkiest sky. Meticulous planning, silly standing. It's a denial, simply wild.
Studios.
Hey!
There's quite a bit that we need to get done in this park.
Yeah, a little bit later than we'd planned. I've got a feeling we're not going to get everything done. But
no, it's Cropper Street. It's open till 9?
I think so, yeah.
9, so...
8 or 9.
Got 5.5 hours, roughly. There's snacks we need to eat. There's...
rides we need to ride.
Yep, there's shopping we need to shop.
And shows we need to show. I've got a feeling that we won't get Beauty and the Beast in.
No. But hey ho, enjoy what we got.
Exactly.
Right. Let's head on in. So, we've not vlogged since we've been in, so we've been in the park, checked a few shops. Well, a shop. Well, Mitch.
Bumped into the restroom.
Well, we went into the restroom.
Oh, sorry. And then we bumped into Jamie.
For God's sake, he has one job.
I'm not very good at it.
No. Come on then.
Hey Jamie.
Come on.
We had a bit of a catch up with him. We've not seen him for quite a while. So just enjoyed the air conditioning while chatting to him. Now we're at Walt Express. Gonna get a quick bite to eat. Because we've not eaten all day. And I'm hungry. So we're in the Walt Express and we've ordered the chicken tenders. 4 chicken strips. Honey mustard, some ketchup, more honey mustard. Lunch. Then we massively underestimated the size of these desserts. We got the Wookiee cookie, I mean just look at the size of that. It is huge. Here comes Liam back with his Fanta. and the 50th Shimmering Blondie.
People are just filling up their own water bottles full of Fanta and Sprite and stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
That's bad. Not cricket. Right, we'll dig in and let you know what we think of the dessert.
It is now. Do a spoon?
I think we're going to be okay.
Indiana Jones.
Yeah. past the woman. Real trouble. Right, Violet, push the flashing button to take off. Violet on the left, move your stick to fly right and left. I was just about to say that. Violet on the right, pull back on the stick to fly up and push forward to fly down. Watch it. This thing will be the end. Left pilot, hit the booster. Now let's go get that Croatia. Right pilot, make the jump to light speed.
This is Agent Carter, isn't it?
Where you saw us last, but we finished our evening at the Hollywood Studios. It was a good evening, wasn't it? Yeah, it was a really good evening. We got everything done there that we wanted to, other than Beauty and the Beast. But can't get everything done every trip, so we got the rides done, we did some shopping, and then we left there. We went to Wendy's, but Wendy's was only doing a drive-through, and we didn't want to do a drive-through. So we've now found ourselves at Denny's, our first time having a dinner here. So I'm going to flip the camera and show you what we've got.
And Denny's is open 24 hours.
Yes, it is. So I've gone for the...
I don't know.
Dipper melt or something. But I've gone for it without cheese. So it's a pot roast sandwich, toasty essentially, with fries and... French onion dipping sauce, and Liam's gone for a bourbon chicken sizzler, which was the other thing I was eyeing up, so I'm hoping to nick a bit of his.
So it's chicken, broccoli, peppers, mushrooms, and potato. Just try the potato. It's like roasties.
Good sauce. I've probably yet again made the wrong decision.
This means like I've not seen any chicken yet. Not on the top.
Yeah, wherever could it be? Huh? You can try some chicken.
Oh.
Oh, is the broccoli good? That is what sold at you from the picture. Try some chicken. Come on.
Oh.
Good?
Mm.
Good, good. That's what it's about. If it's shaky, it's because I'm freezing, by the way.
Mmm.
Mmm. Very good. Where's my cutlery? Some of my meat's popped out. Just push it back in. So it's in Texas toast, so is that garlic toast? Lucky you. Into the dip. Mmm. That was good. Oh, man, oh, man. Want to try a bit?
No, thank you.
Oh, I think you should.
No, thank you.
That is lovely. Just try a chip or something.
No, thank you.
Okay. Just like a really rich gravy.
No, thank you. I'm taking pictures while you're eating. Oh, you sexy beast, you.
At least not one more.
Real good?
Yeah, lovely.
Right, blend it here. Well, eat our dinner.
So we are back in the room. Denny's was great. Food was really, really good. It came to $34 before tip. So that was really good. And then we were able to save 20% as well, because with the eat and play card that we got through attraction tickets when we bought our tickets, gave us 20% off as well, so that was good.
But we're tipping the 20%, that was it.
Yeah. But it's been a good day, isn't it? The evening's been really good. Got some great PhotoPass pictures today, so I'll put some in here, and another one here, and another one here.
You haven't got to do
that. And another one here. And one more here. But yeah, we've got some really good pictures. It's been a good day. So just, yeah. Ready for bed now. I'm so tired. Tomorrow we are Typhoon Lagoon in the morning. Trying to sort that little camera out. And then Epcot, hoping to get on Guardians again. And then possibly outlets. Oh no, we're Old Red tomorrow, aren't we? Old Red for dinner tomorrow. So, yeah. We shall see you next week.
Teddy byes.